glad he hasn't killed his plants.
Yes, it's beginning to look a lot like Christmas in the Fox 8 studio. Just because summer's over does not mean plant season is.
No, our friend AJ Petiti.
The one and only.
This is a big deal.
The one and only.
He's such a superstar. We barely get him.
Wow.
Anyway,
yeah, he is.
He's going to highlight different house plants.
I'm to the point now I want to be like AJ when I grow up.
I just want to be like Wayne. So
come on, man.
That's good. So anyway, but yeah, there's a lot that you can do. Obviously, poinsettias for Christmas, there's nothing that puts on a show.
Now, can I ask you, can you put those outside?
No.
Do you have to live in a certain part of the country?
Well, you got to be in, like, I mean, Southern California,
like
Florida,
Dallas. I was watching somebody on Instagram. They live in Dallas.
They put
them in their planters outside.
You put them outside here, they're done.
They're dead.
They're done.
Gone.
I mean, you can just watch it happen. They will be very unhappy very quickly. But there's a lot of plants that you could do that are great for around the season.
Can I just say this looks like it's artificial, but it's not.
No. These are bromeliads.
Gorgeous, man.
And this will bloom for 3, 4, 5 months.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah.
Is it hard to take care of?
No, it's easy. It's very simple. Put it in a bright area.
Maybe I should take that one instead.
And then there's one trick. You actually just water it right in the middle.
Okay, with just like, okay,
just
not
water.
Ice.
Just, no,
water.
Just water.
Just water.
Just
right water. In the middle.
Just regular water.
Man, you smell good. What kind of cologne you got on today?
Wow, okay. You know what?
So, you put the water
the in the middle. I'm sorry. I hate to break it up.
I'm just saying.
Okay. Well, you know, shower in the morning.
That's
cool.
That's nice. That's pretty.
But yeah, but these are low maintenance.
That's pretty.
You can kind of set it, forget it. And then same thing actually with these anthurium.
Mm-hmm.
These will bloom for months at a time. They don't take a lot of work. They don't take a lot of anything. Just really just water them. And then you could make it like a cool little dish garden like this. Just kind of mix things up. Put Christmas ferns in. Mm-hmm. And really just make things beautiful.
Wow.
Poinsettias, the couple things that you want to keep in mind.
Yes.
Back to what we were talking about in terms of cold weather.
Yes.
You want to keep them away from a draft.
Got it.
And then they look great when you mass them together. So put like three or four in a corner.
Yep.
Really
bulk out
the color.
We do that at church. You got them all massed together.
That's
it's
pretty.
It's beautiful.
Yeah.
And then just try to water them just away from the leaves. So you can either use the ice cubes. Mm-hmm. You could use just direct water. You want
How
to water
often?
Them
mm-hmm.
about every day, every other day, but not a ton.
Not a ton.
And then especially if you've got the sleeve on the bottom. If you are watering every day, you really just want to check the bottom of the sleeve and just make sure that it's not holding water down there. Because, you know, otherwise, if it's sitting in water, it's just as bad as it drying out.
Right. Mm-hmm.
So many plants you could just kind of zhuzh up for Christmas and just kind of make it fun.
That's pretty.
Oh, it's a Christmas cactus.
A cactus?
Oh, yeah.
So you don't have to water that as much or what? How do you take care of this?
That's a legit cactus, so you really want to back off the watering on it.
Really?
Yeah, but
it's once
every couple weeks. You want to keep it in a warm place, bright lights. But they're beautiful, and you know, when it comes to getting them to bloom, you want to, you know, kind of you play around with the light. And there's sheets that we've got online
that
you can
take a look. Will it open up bigger than that?
Oh yeah, they're beautiful.
Oh,
they'll be the flowers on that will be at least 2-3 inches long. They're spectacular.
That's good stuff.
Yeah,
yeah.
And then you can also take this show kind of outside the house.
Yeah.
Stuff that's great. So these are just pine cones to put together.
Isn't that pretty?
So you can either just get the pine cones.
Isn't that pretty? It's a mistletoe. No. Not today.
Poor Wiz. Walk out of here, Bruce.
I'll take this home.
See what I got to deal with every day?
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh.
No, that's really pretty. I like that.
Yeah.
That is pretty.
No, but stuff
take it
that
home
you can,
now.
You
no,
can
I
make
will.
This at home, and it's easy.
Yes.
So,
okay.
And then just same
Ooh.
Thing with the greens. You can kind of take a look at the greens. Mm-hmm. We've got pots on the end, so, you know, we were talking with John earlier. He's got mums that were in full bloom. They're finally done. I mean, it's end of November now.
Okay.
So
now, what about this stuff over here? These are not hard to take care of.
No.
Why? Because I have one at home.
What?
No,
and
it's still alive.
Yeah, it's phenomenal. No, you put it in bright indirect light.
Okay.
Just keep it evenly moist.
Okay.
It's a Norfolk pine.
Yeah,
and
they're
so
beautiful.
They're beautiful. And then this is the same thing. This is a cypress.
How sweet.
So, and it's just really nice.
That's soft.
Same thing.
Yeah.
But the Norfolks and Wayne, those will get 5, 6, 8 feet tall.
No.
Oh, those will get huge.
I'll come back when I grow it.
It's still alive,
but
it's not
growing. Is he going to put his in a different pot?
Eventually. You can kind of take a look and see if you want to bump it up.
Now, can I ask you a question real quick? Because I knew, which is easier to take care of, this one or that one?
This one you're going to get more longevity out of.
Oh, okay. That one.
Once these are once they're done blooming, they're one and done. They'll never rebloom again. So the Norfolk pine, boom. And then, I mean, obviously, and then there's this guy. I mean, the lifelike stuff is getting better and better.
He'll last a lifetime, right?
That'll last a lifetime.
This is fake, but it's still gorgeous. So
this is pretty.
If that's beautiful. What you love. I don't want to waste any more time.
Yeah.
We have to get to my favorite.
Okay. Yes. So
this is outdoor.
Outdoor. So these are just, I mean, fresh greens. So it's what we've got here. You can either, you know, obviously buy them pre-made, or you can make them yourself. And just really green. So these are white pine. This is some Fraser, some cedar. We've got some pine in there. And so if you've got, you know, pots outside that you used all summer that you've got the roots in there, that is the perfect base to make that in.
Really?
So you can just buy the pine. And it's going to take a little trial and error. but you just pack it full of stuff. So just get some pine. You want to work, same
this
thing with your containers.
This is very nice.
Oh, I know.
You work higher to lower, and then you could just fill it, and it's gorgeous, and that'll hold up.
And how often do I have to water it?
You don't touch it. It's all cut
how
stuff.
How nice is that?
And it's outside.
God, that's amazing. And Margaret, we don't have to
you mean
water
even
it.
When it snows and heavy and
no,
it's still
no, it's good.
Good.
It's good.
Both of these?
Okay. Yeah, and that'll hold up all winter long.
How
so,
nice is that?
Yeah, you know, I can get you one.
You can de-Christmas it if you want to once you get in the winter months, but that'll stick in that planter pretty much all year.
That's
and then
gorgeous.
Next spring, take the soil, take everything, just kind of start fresh, and you'll be ready to go.
And we have to go, but there are wreaths, too.
Oh, that's right. The beautiful
wreaths.
That's
my favorite.
That's very nice.
I want that screenshot.
I know.
Zoom put me in an antler one year.
Hey, TV. Thank you, AJ.
Thank you, man. Thank you, guys.
Always good to see you, man.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.